My name is Sanjay Sundaram. I'm a visual artist based in Ottawa since 2013. And my work has been described as hallucinatory urban landscapes. I was born and brought up in New Delhi, India. My father was a cartoonist and my mother was a fine artist. There was a happy, free-thinking and creative environment at home, and really never a lack of advice or art materials. At university, I studied architecture, but soon after graduating, I realized I had to be involved with visual arts a lot more. And so I've planned my life around that. By 2013, my art practice was fairly well established in India. I was showing regularly in group and solo shows, participating in art fairs and residencies, and had exhibitions in the US, UK, Italy, and of course various cities in India. The decision to immigrate to Canada at that point was a hard one in that sense. Fortunately, things seem to have worked out fine, though I've noticed a lot more references to flight and to change have appeared in my work. I continue to show regularly in Canada and abroad. My work has been collected, perhaps given the environmental themes, it's been collected by organizations such as the World Wildlife Fund for Nature, UNICEF, the United Nations Development Programme, the David Sheldrick Wildlife Trust, the City of Ottawa, and most recently the Government of India. Thematically, I've often found my inspiration in these large, intensely urban spaces, such as city centers and business districts. When I was studying architecture, I used to look at such areas from a design and a planning aspect. But I've kept returning to these scenes for my art too. Basically, when I step back and I observe them, I find these places to be places of everyday horrors and everyday magic. I can imagine large simians that appear on skyscrapers built on the ruins of their forests, cars that spout golden flowers instead of smoke, and maybe giant deer that hide at traffic intersections and pretend to be statues. In New Delhi, in Mumbai, London, New York, and now Ottawa, I found, at least for me, that they have all the same sense. They have a similar interplay between the natural and the man-made, and perhaps similar consequences of unending growth. I quite enjoy the technical aspects of these paintings too. If you look closely at works such as the tower, where about 30 skyscrapers and monuments combine together to form a single cohesive structure, it requires a fairly thorough understanding of, let's say, orthographic projections and perspective to create this. Each building in that painting needs to be drawn in the appropriate scale and perspective depending on its position in the tower. Else it could easily look like a collage of building simply pasted on. Even when the buildings distort, like in the painting The Road of 12 Pillars, the distortions need to be done with the rules in mind. Sometimes the pencil sketches for these works can take as long as the actual painting, and for me these are equally enjoyable to do. I have explored such themes in different media as well, sometimes large-scale tessellations and installations. And recently my series with QR codes is on similar lines, where the QRs that I design and embed in paintings provide a parallel layer of communication when the works are viewed through a phone. My show at Shenkman next year is entitled The Artist as a Meat-Eating Coal Company. It is a reaction to the times we live in. I heard about climate change 25 years ago, along with many artists, architects, designers, and filmmakers of that time. I set out to spread awareness and hopefully make things right. More than half of all the carbon emissions humans have put out in the atmosphere have come in that time frame, in the last 25 to 30 years. This exhibition is an acknowledgement of our lack of influence, a moody celebration of failure. I have some pieces worked out that revel in their uselessness, but I am still not fully decided how it will play out. Maybe I'll replace them all with paintings of science facts, and I have to figure out a way to transport my works on a bicycle.